The journey of Ashpra actually starts, it started in somewhere around 2001 when we just thought to launch our own brand as a tailor just for the damaged jewelry, and finally we launched it on 2003. And initially it was only for the diamonds, and we were foreseeing that the coming future was only for the brands, and just limiting ourselves as a family jeweler would stop us from growing. That's why we planned to come up with a brand, and I think we were the first retailer of North India who launched a diamond jewelry as a brand. And again, we made the diamond jewelry business, we tried to make it more and more transparent. We educated our customers about the four C's of the diamond. We educated them about the Rapaport chart and how to calculate the price of it. And that really helped us. And today, we have converted all our stores in the name of Ashpra. And our decision which we took at that time is really helping us a lot.
So how do you see the diamond market in India? So it's always been said that India is a country where we love a lot of jewels and diamonds. But there has been a lot of influx of something called American diamond, right? Which probably because of the cost effectiveness, a lot of people are preferring. But still the market is there. But do you see a real kind of a challenge with these international brands coming to India with new concepts, new designs? Or do you think the market is still for the Indian brands to grow?
I don't think so there is any challenge. In my opinion, we know much more about the taste and jewelry designs of Indian customers. And again, diamond jewelry business will grow, definitely it will grow, because when a person who will compare it with artificial diamonds will definitely will prefer buying it, but only if it is made more and more transparent to the customers.
What are the challenges you have faced since you started this brand? Like, you know, you said you were a jewelry shop, but you wanted to make it as a brand. So what are the challenges you initially faced, and how did you tackle those challenges?
The most challenge was ki when we started that, as we are from a very small town of UP, Purvanchal, and most of the jewelers, they are selling the jewelry without giving certificate, without hallmark. And when we started a brand, it was really a challenge for us to educate the customer that what are the four C's of the diamond, how the price should be calculated, and what's the difference between a certified jewelry and a non-certified jewelry, and what's the difference between a hallmark jewelry and a non-hallmark jewelry. So that was the main challenge which we have to go through during that time. But that challenge is really paying us today.